a confession. I'm not a technologist. I'm not a developer. And when you get into the technical questions, I'm going to defer to my colleague, Mike, who's my comrade in a lot of activities that we do. I'm just a fan of the future. When I see something really cool and it's within my pocketbook, I'll buy it. And this is one of the things that I saw at an expert workshop at the Institute for the Future, when Matterport, a person from Matterport was demoing the technology. I found out that the developer model is only $350. I thought that was cool. Grab a hold of it. And I want to thank my colleague, Alex Voda, who actually put this presentation together, because I've been back-to-back-to-back meetings the last few days. So he should be giving this presentation, because he's the real user of this at the Institute. I bought it, gave it to him and some of the young guns at our office. I'll talk into this instead. Is that what I'm going to do? Okay. So back in the day, 100 years ago, the Lumiere brothers created this movie with this train that came right at you, and people who had never seen cinema before shrieked and screamed and were in awe of this train that was about to jump off and into their world. Maybe that was true, maybe not. Some people think it's just myth and lore. But we are now moving into a world where something is similar is happening to us. Virtual reality is approachable. This is a product that raised $2.4 million, and they're going to come out with this model sometime next year is the expected delivery date. You can buy one now. You'll have it in a few days. If you send them $350, it'll be the squarish, not as advanced one. This one has twice the resolution, but it's in our grasp. It was so successful that a lot of applications and gaming companies decided, hey, we're going to start utilizing this as an interface to interact with games. So it looks like it's starting to happen. It's here, and that's what really got me excited. When we started to use it in the workplace, it became a social interaction. And you may not know, this is Aerie. Aerie's having a great time using it. But one is how you interact with it, but also how your colleagues and your friends interact with you. Sometimes they're nice and shake your chair. Sometimes they're not nice and smack you in the face as you're about to dream or something like that. But I think you're just riding the roller coaster here, and you're trying to, people move when they ride the roller coaster. Sometimes they get a little nauseous. We actually have a video here of somebody that's going through it. We have Nick that's gonna give Dylan a little extra ride here, and Alex is off to the side. Oh, that away. Need to learn how to press play here.
I know, the shit's so weird.
No, he said no because he got nauseous, and that's common for about, 30% of the people that I'd say have used it get nauseous. And we know it's fake, we know it's not real, we can just take it off and we're good. And if you go on YouTube and watch some videos, you see that some people are just horrified by it, and one guy is afraid of whatever roller coaster phobia is, he's afraid of roller coasters, and his friends make him wear it. He's just having the worst time of his life. But people get into it. Ben's over here. This is Ben. Ben's actually trying to reach out and experience what's in front of him because it feels so real. He's actually holding the desk here as he's going on the roller coaster. And we also get a chance to walk through other people's lives. This is a simulation through Matterport. If I have time, I'm going to show you the video at the end of Matterport. They go through with this camera, a 3D camera, so it's got two cameras, and they're just walking through with a wand and just taking a picture or a video picture, lots of pictures of every single place in a room. They're piecing together that huge big file, then they're uploading it and allowing you to walk through virtual space. We are now able to hack this. It's an open developer ecosystem, so lots of people are going to build tools on it, build things on it. One thing I think that will obviously happen is this is a high resolution display. You just slide this into the front of the viewer. I wouldn't be surprised if some of the phone companies come out with their version of that with other partners. And we're also finding that as you want to walk, you don't want to hit the arrow key. So here's a device that is also on Kickstarter. You can buy it now, I think, also for like $350. And it's parabolic, so you step up and you kind of slide back into the middle, but you can walk around in space, which is really cool. So where are we going? Gaming and entertainment, that's the first area. Opportunities for learning, I think that's the biggest area. I have a 23-year-old brother-in-law who's a biology student, this is what he sees. He wants to see molecules in front of him and manipulate them in interesting ways. I'm gonna jump down and share that video real fast. So this is what sold it on me. You can walk, once a video has been made and it's slow internet connection, so it's gonna take a while. But it's pretty high res. Once you upload the file, if you have a vacation home, if you want to rent a place out, if you want to check out something on Airbnb in advance, and it's not as bright as it is here.
Full screen.
Yeah. Maybe it's still not as bright, but it's so lifelike. If you want to experience a place before you buy it or before you rent it, or a cottage, this is it. If you want to videotape a crime scene after a crime has occurred, and then go back and take the jury through it, this is it. Just go to Matterport.com and you'll see all kinds of applications. One company with a camera built on top of this platform, or in connection with this platform, has come up with. This is virtual reality, it's not augmented reality, it's virtual reality. I see this as something you do while you're sitting or standing and experiencing something completely different in a way that's more tangible. It's not something that you'll walk around down the street in or drive down the road in, but it makes reality so approachable. You gotta watch this video with brighter light and at a real speed. It makes a lot more sense. So, am I done? Is that five? That wasn't five. I can't talk that fast, can I? I never talk that fast. That's all I have to say.
Okay.
For me, the biggest cue for it, or coolest factor for it, for me, is going to be entertainment. I studied chemistry in college, and that was one of the most difficult things, is you read something about a chemical interaction, or you see just diagram of it. That's hard to visualize in your brain. This makes it so approachable. Just being able to manipulate, move things around, just dive into it, explore it. I'll be here outside later to show people roller coasters, space, ice world, all these other things that people have created. So happy to show that for people.